gotta be okay, it's official. I'm dedicating that song to this year, to everybody who has kept watching Scoop and Scoop, everybody who has taken the time out to comment on that YouTube upload, to comment on that Facebook upload, that Instagram upload, that Twitter upload. If you have basically just been there with us, njagala bagambe, we got in the words of Saha, mbagala bidi, bidi 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 bidi. Welcome to the show. It's the 24th of December. It's Christmas Eve. I'm in a festive mood. Whew, I got my Santa hat on, and then someone had to go and like piss me off and say, Tina, you're not supposed to be wearing the Santa elf or something, whatever hat. You're supposed to be dressed up like the Grinch. I say no, I'm not the Grinch. I love Christmas. My name is Tina Fierce One, and in the spirit of festivities, in the spirit of giving, in the spirit of love, with the magic of Christmas, I welcome you to this episode of Scoop and Scoop. Woo, child! Like, Katoro Wama got so angry that he ended up having to put his fist on somebody. Now, I have to ask the question. Is this the first time someone has insulted Katoro Wama? For crying out loud, he is Katoro Wama. Is this the first time that somebody has insulted you to the core, to the person that you felt you had to come out and just bring out the animosity out of you? I mean, I'm not even judging him, because there's certain people that will push your buttons. But then again, it's Katoro Wama. For me, at times, Katoro Wama looks like an insult waiting to happen. Kato! Ebintu bya Ebony ziba kaimbira drama kitazi Afri Talent, yani omulala Diamond Ensemble and Productions. Mbana manyu wabileka yeri ku theater. Like, for real. Let me tell you certain things that you should never do as a Ugandan politician. One, play pretend that someone has attacked you, because as the Ugandans are seated watching that someone attack you, we are like, it's alright. We feel that same way every day. Like, we won't feel the sympathy because you're in politics. It's part of the game. Another thing by now I expected Katoro Wama to be comfortable with, it's how to channel emotion while you're on camera. Katoro has been acting for the longest time ever. That's why probably this was a very well-acted scene. You see, we cannot help it. People, like the masses and the general public, believes he is still Katoro Wama. Oligwe tumanyi. The comedian. So when he comes out to say something serious, we don't take it seriously. But then I think that this is the point where he's supposed to work on his take me serious look. Like, do you think he has that? Because Katoro Wama just looking at you like this, even if he doesn't say none, you finna bust out and laugh. Then, ekibuzo kye naba dancing go kwa galobuza. Ruamiti, why are you watching porn? Why are you WhatsApping one of your new baby mamas? What were you doing with the phone? An altercation is breaking out live on your TV set. You are the host and the mediator, and all you could do was temuluana, temuluana, wagai, temuluana. Nede choto chogera, okay. I was like, what the fuck? Dude. Two men are trying to put fists on each other and you're on your phone. She must have been important. Or, again, since I like to buy into conspiracy, you knew it was going to happen. Not everyone is going to be measured by Bobby Wine's threshold. I hate that. I hate it. I hate it. Every parliamentarian who is inside there was voted by his constituents and they wanted him there. But you're not going to start pitting every politician against Bobby Wine. Bobby Wine, nah, guys. Let everybody represent for their constituents the best way that they know how to. But as for you, Katoro, hala me. I could take improv acting lessons from you and script writing, but what we be chaganya? So holla at me, I'll take those from you. You can take a thing or two about having a hard, thick as nails type of skin and soul. Anyway, news coming in from Magufuliland is Diamond Platnumz and Rayvanny over the weekend, actually not just over the weekend, it started within last week, were banned to perform Mwanza, the song. The reason, they say it has way too much sexual connotations to it. And for that purpose, they said, Mujeo gasia mwemwagala kono naba Tanzania ba femuleke na bimba mbwa mwe. Okay, they could have said it like that, but in a lighter note, right? Like a lighter note, on a lighter note. Anyway, Diamond Platnumz came out on his different socials and he apologized. Now I was like, wait, how nasty does a song gotta be for an entire government to know about it? Do you think Museveni heard about Panadoa Basajali Amomani? But hey, in Tanzania, well, the people are woke and the Ministry for Integrity and Morals and whatever they call it down there is awake, very awake. Listen to this song. I speak a little, no, I don't speak a little bit of Kiswahili. I understand a bit of Kiswahili. Now the song, there's that color in where it goes. Apparently that's the line that means something sexual, which brings the question. I think Lokodo knows a lot of Swahili because that is was one of the reasons he gave for wanting to cancel Nyege Nyege this year. It was like the word Nyege Nyege itself is just bad. But yo, Tanzanians, manae, nama mutulekemu, aren't you tired of kubeiranga mwabaliye mabega? Like, the things that happened in Tanzania in 2009. No, like, Tanzania could be in 2010 while the rest of the world is in 2020. You get what I'm saying? And they're comfortable with it. Because if you're going to stop Diamond Platnumz from performing a song like that, right? I do understand in your language it could definitely mean something, but I don't think his sense of moral has depleted to a point where he's just going to come out and blatantly just sing about sex. And if he does, will it be the first? If you're going to ban Diamond Platnumz and Rayvanny for singing Mwanza the song, then please, by all means, check Beyonce, Jay-Z, Katy Perry, Rihanna, Nicki Minaj, all of them. Check all the American music, especially Chris Brown. That boy can talk about sex in different ways and angles. Take all of them off the airwaves so that you can keep that beautiful young Tanzania beautiful and great. And it's a good thing. I'm not saying this in a bad way, but it's the hypocrisy. And this is not the first time they've done this to Diamond Platnumz. You remember sometime at the beginning of the year, they had actually banned him again from singing particular music. I'm like, dude, what's up with Magufuli? Why don't he vibe with the government? What's up? Because the government before Magufuli was Team Diamond Platnumz, you know? Oh, what was his name? Chikwete? Jakaya. Jakaya was Team Let's Do the Music. Let's put Tanzania back on the map. And he helped give Diamond Platnumz that boost. So the moment Jakaya Chikwete left like this, Magufuli was like, Temuja kusiru walira wano, I have better morals. Anyway, so he won't be performing the song. Okay, Bangambye Vic Pamega yabadde alina follow-up concert of his journey, Sefu journey, and it was in Kazo, right? Mwechabaddewo is that nature had different plans. This time it wasn't the people. We don't know if the people were going to show up, but nature had its own plans. Kasawe konambo kakubyeka amazi, tenti zonane zitoba. Nacho cha musaze echo, don't forget, eche mukono cha mukolera. But then I'm like, why? Wachi? Why does it, when it rains, it pours on fixed life? And then I got the answer. There is no flying chance in life. You can sleep with Sheila Gashumba and expect good tidings along your way. What is the opposite of ebisima? Ebifini. Nyine ebifini. Obusapatu. Sorry. Anyway, that is what happened in Fix's world. In another world, though, Joseph Mayanja, aka Kamilioni, Kamiliology, against the Yetondera Balamu. Na still kubivulu tebana musako because as we looked at all Balam's different concerts that he has, everybody will be in within this period. We were shocked to see that Chameleon wasn't on any of the lineup. But apparently, like on Saturday or something, he went down, Balam, they sat down, he apologized, and I think they're back at one. But Tetumanyo Bakubivulubana Mwongezako, or he could be a curtain raiser at some point. Does that clearly state that Balam Akiriza, Nebivulu, Ebidako, concert here next year to Genda G, Itachi Mokama? You know, Yabade Saba Saba. And again, I go back to the Mau Mau and Gipidi and Labongo Revolution. The Nilo Hamites. Saba Saba Nilo Hamites. But it's a good thing, you know. We always have to toss to friendships that have worked. And clearly, Chameleon's friendship and Balam has worked for quite some time. So this is them, you know, testing the sands of time and see if they will still be able to work together. It was again an achievement. Anyway, that and a lot much more. But no, I'm lying. There's not that much more going on. It's like all our celebrities are in hibernation. Ataba singa tebagenze ko nebweru abantu abasama baganya okujja Kampala ne basako gano okutwala abayimbi babayimbira zimbakogu. All our artists are in town. All of them are going to have normal Christmases like us, so which clearly means I do not have stories, but like I always do, I never come empty handed. So I'll see you again tomorrow on the first Noel. Is that what they call the first Noel? Yes. I will find you. I'll see you tomorrow. And we're definitely going to be talking about Christmas shade. I love Christmas shade. Other than that, Merry Christmas, people. I was supposed to sing for you, but my voice took leave. But we shall do this probably tomorrow. I'm Tina Fierce One. It's quite simple. At Tina Fierce One on Twitter. And on Facebook, we are at Scoop and Scoop and at Tina Fierce One. Not forgetting on Instagram, it's at Tina Fierce One with an H. Ho, ho, ho to all the hotations out there. If you get what I'm saying. I'm out. Peace.